Like this interview with Seth Rollins from WWE? Subscribe to WrestleZone Radio on iTunes or your podcast app of choice for more exclusive audio from the biggest names in all of wrestling, plus 4 episodes of WrestleZone Daily every single week. Special thanks to 101 WKQX Radio in Chicago for hooking this up. A lot of people say burn it down when he comes out to the ring. You know him, WWE superstar Seth Rollins in town, the Allstate Arena, and I'll still say it, the best venue for wrestling in the world. Just my humble opinion. 4 nights of action, Friday night SmackDown, NXT TakeOver War Games, Sunday night with Survivor Series, and Monday night with Raw. It's a special time when you guys come back to Chicago, isn't it?
Well, first of all, I will say, you might be correct on that.
Okay.
Allstate is a special building. It just set up really nicely for wrestling, and we've had a ton of incredible events there over the years. So you might be right about that. And this weekend is incredible. You kind of ran it down, but yeah, it's going to be wild, man. The fans are kind of flocking in from all over the world for a big weekend, and so we're looking forward to the energy in the city and in the arena.
Let's talk about the energy. Wednesday night, you get to go back to Full Sail. A little bit of your roots. You're leading Team Raw. There's a faction from SmackDown, but NXT's red hot now. Now they're on weekly network television. There's stuff at a fever pitch. People picking their sides, and you certainly added a whole lot more chaos to the element there. What does it feel like to have all three brands? They've done Raw versus SmackDown, but NXT is this whole new wild element that you certainly are familiar with.
Yeah, I mean, you know, NXT is a favorite child, Obviously, and so they're getting the royal treatment right now, but they're stepping up to the plate. You know, they got a ton of really talented guys and girls down there, and they've been making waves. And they've earned their spot, and they've gotten a television show on USA Network on Wednesday nights, basically on their own, you know, but building it from the grassroots, from where we were 9 years ago when we started that thing, or whatever, 7 years ago at this point. But yeah, they're doing well, and it's certainly added an element of chaos. I know there's a lot more bodies to go around, so it feels like every show it's unpredictable. You never know when something's going to happen. So is it overkill? Maybe, but it's been a fun couple of weeks at the very least.
There were a handful of different things just recently where you've had interactions with people maybe people haven't seen you with before or have only seen you with recently. There was a small one. Bunch of different bodies laying around the ring, and you and Tommaso Ciampa got to just share a couple of glances there in the ring, and someone described me as dropping a drop of blood in a tank full of sharks. Fans lost their mind at the idea of you and Ciampa in the ring together at some point. Is that something that excites you?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the opportunity to match up with fresh guys is really cool, and I've gotten the opportunity over the last couple of weeks to do that in the ring, whether it be Adam Cole or Walter, or you know, mixing it up with some of the NXT guys who've come to Raw to make some waves. It's been a blast, and Ciampa's a guy that I've admired for a long time from afar. He and I never really crossed paths in the ring, and so that was sort of the first interaction, at least that I can recall, and sort of the first interaction where we're both at different levels, you know, and so I can only assume that at some point down the line, our paths will cross again, hopefully in a one-on-one contest, and we can give fans who are clamoring for a match of that caliber one that they deserve.
This Sunday, there's 3 different teams, 5 different guys on each team. You're leading Team Raw. The structure of wrestling is sometimes very challenging to put a match like this together. How challenging is it to kind of put this together going in and then, of course, execute with that many different people?
You know, we'll find out when we get there on Sunday. You know, I've had a lot of very interesting matches in my career, a lot of first-time matches, a lot of weird matches, a lot of things I've had to struggle through to get the job done to the best of my ability. And I like to think that I've done an admirable job, at the very least, most of the time. Most of the time, a pretty darn good job. And this one's going to be fun. You know, you've got a lot of bodies. I don't even know how it's going to look. I don't know how they're going to shoot this with cameras. I just don't know. There's 15 dudes standing on the ring. You know, I don't know.
Hey, somebody has to go sit on the steps.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know how it's going to look. So, I mean, from a production standpoint, from a putting the match together standpoint, from how it's going to look and feel, how long it's going to take, it's a lot of eliminations. And so I don't know. It's a mystery to me, but I guess that's the fun part, is there's always something new.
Are you ready for the tough questions?
Oh, let's bring in the tough questions.
There's been a lot of chatter about you, about what you should and shouldn't say, and you're this guy, and you have come and waved the flag of WWE as the landscape in the wrestling world has changed. And some people have lashed out at you for that. No, you should calm down. And one person who's told you to not hit up the Twitter is someone that Chicago's very familiar with.
Oh, yeah.
CM Punk is back with WWE television on WWE Backstage, obviously with FS1. And this week he said, you should stop tweeting. And you said, fight me. And you even added a little bit more to that. And I'll just let you kind of comment further.
You know, it's a good bit of banter back and forth. The bottom line is, the funny thing is, for me, for a guy telling me that I need to look for relevancy, here's someone who's been, you know, in the doldrums for the last few years because he got his butt kicked in the octagon so bad he didn't want to show his face anywhere. And now he shows back up. On a WWE show, it's called WWE Backstage. You can say it's an FS1 show all you want, which it is, and you might be paid by Fox, but that show doesn't exist without our company, the company that you left 5 years ago. So say whatever you want, play it however you want. That's what Punk always does. But at the end of the day, if he wants to come on a show and run his mouth about me and about a company that he has no part of for the last 5 years, then of course I'm going to stand up for it. This is a place that has given me everything that I've ever wanted in my life. Not only for me, but it's provided me a living for my family, for people that I love, that I care about. And of course I'm going to have its back. I'm not going to sit here and let you push it around and push me around and act like you're so cool. You couldn't, you know, bust a cherry in a fruit fight, dude. So I want to make some money. So if CM Punk wants to talk all the smack in the world, I've invited him a million times to now come to my ring, come to my domain on live television where you can't hide behind anything, no desk in LA. Come. Let's do this thing, man. Let's fight. Let's fight it out like men.
What is that match like? Where would you like that match to be? I think Sunday seems like a fair setting. This is a guy who, what would that reaction be like? Obviously, this is a guy who says he's not actively pursuing it.
Sure.
You know, WrestleMania is on the horizon, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, to me, look, we're in his backyard, right? I mean, literally, we could probably get to his house in like 10 minutes. I don't know where he lives, but we could probably get there pretty quickly.
Blue Line's not far from here, man.
Yeah, so he knows where I'm going to be Sunday and Monday, maybe Saturday, maybe Friday. Who knows?
At this point, with everything that's going on.
Yeah, you don't know. But he knows for sure where I'm going to be on Sunday and Monday. So, you know, maybe he's hiding out in L.A. waiting, you know, to sit behind his little desk. Or, you know, maybe he's a little keyboard warriorish too. Who knows? I don't know what he's up to. So, bottom line is, wherever, whenever he wants to do the thing, if he wants to man up and do it, I'm there. For me, the only place the match happens is WrestleMania in the main event, because that's the only reason I'm picking a fight with him. I got no other interest in than that. So if he's interested, it's out there, man. Anytime you're ready, let's
well,
go.
Well, looks like we have a headline already. I do want to ask you about this. We mentioned CM Punk. He's a guy who has a deep spiritual connection to Chicago.
Yeah.
You know, but you do too. You do too. And I got to see you come up the first time I saw AAW, Berwyn, Illinois, the Berwyn Eagles Club. And you really were a featured player there for a long time in a wonderful, gritty, great dive bar of a wrestling venue in the Berwyn Eagles Club. Tell me about performing for fans like that and now getting now to come back every few times a year and do it in the big house at Allstate Arena. There's got to be something special about that.
Yeah, I mean, I got a connection to Chicago. Funny thing is, all those people that went to Berwyn are probably the same fans that are telling me I'm not cool now. Funny how that works. But
you liked them when you were paying $1 for a beer.
It was a really awesome place to cut your teeth in the industry. Chicago is, in general, it's such a great wrestling town. It has been on every level for me, whether I was in AAW in Berwyn or the Frontier Fieldhouse for Ring of Honor or now Allstate for WWE. Crowds have always been awesome. They've always, you know, you give me a hard time, but I appreciate it. And I think when there's a mutual respect and a lot of hard work goes into what I do, it always comes out pretty well for me. And so, man, there's tons of memories. I loved working in the Berwyn Eagles Club. I loved it. And it was cool to build that promotion from literally, I mean, when I started working there 15 years ago, it was nothing. It was Safari Stew. And like you said, the ticket wasn't the wrestling. It was the dollar beers. That's the only reason we got 50 people into that building. Yeah. And now they're doing so great. And it's awesome to see independent wrestling rise up in the area. And it's just really cool, man. And it was great. I'd love to be back there for a minute.
Seth Rollins a part of the action for WWE. Friday night SmackDown, Saturday night NXT TakeOver War Games. Some limited tickets available for Sunday with Survivor Series and, of course, Monday Night Raw. And you can see it all streaming on the WWE Network.